A local neighborhood association has had enough of the crime. After a string of home invasions, burglaries, and sexual assaults, they want answers from police, and they held a meeting tonight to talk about it. New at 10, WDSU reporter Gina Swanson tells us some arrests have been made, and police are trying to figure out if the crimes are linked. Gina?
Scott, in the last couple of weeks, we've heard about a woman being strangled, two others being tied up, another sexually assaulted. As you can imagine, this has folks in the Carrollton area on edge, but police say they are making some headway in these cases.
The home invasions that we had, those cases are cleared by arrest. We arrested the two Johnson brothers and Mr. Jones as well on those cases.
Police say they were able to catch 21-year-old James Johnson in the act of sexual assault last week on Hickory Street. Investigators also linked him, his brother, 17-year-old Aaron Johnson, and Kevin Jones to a home invasion where two women were tied up and held at gunpoint on Panola Street. It's these types of crimes that led to this community meeting in Carrollton. Neighbors are fed up and want answers. Police say they are clearing a large number of cases.
The solve rates for you second district detectives are the best in the city, okay? Absolutely the best in the city.
It's a tough sell for some in the audience who believe they've seen a spike in crime. Superintendent Surpass says they're monitoring the data and know where to deploy officers. Even Mother Nature had to weigh in.
Within days, Commander Noel and his team were able to catch two guys that were involved in a lot of the burglaries. Spirit's gonna get me.
Neighbors raised concern about NOPD manpower and staffing at the city's 911 call center. It was a broad range of topics from a community whose sole concern is feeling safer in their own homes. While investigators have made some arrests, they are now working to see if the same suspects are linked to even more incidents in the Carrollton area.
The physical descriptions on Adams are different than the three individuals we have in custody. Now, it's not out of the realm of possibility that there's a larger network associated with them.
Now, police are also still looking into a case on Green Street where the woman was strangled by an intruder. Information, police say, is still limited in that case. Scott.
Gina, thanks. Police are encouraging residents to continue to call and report crimes. The department uses that information to determine how to deploy officers. If you have any information that could help police with these cases, call Crime Stoppers at 822-1111.